up, Cougars?
And welcome back to another episode of
Cougar TV.
Guys, are you ready for March Madness?
What do you mean March Madness? March is already crazy enough. Gas prices are insane right now.
I'm not sure what March Madness has to do with gas prices.
Yeah, Kylie, March Madness obviously has to do with basketball. That's why Tom Brady came back and is going to win it for us.
Are you dumb?
Tom Brady plays in the NFL. He doesn't play college basketball.
Well, I think I know more about basketball than you.
Do you think so?
Wanna go?
Us too.
Hope you enjoyed that maddening intro.
We didn't have any music in the halls last Friday, but we have something for you now.
Here's Apex Ox with Edition 2.
What's up, Cougars? We're here with Sydney Byer, another president of Femme Club, and she's going to share three songs by her favorite female artist in honor of Women's History Month. But before we get into that, tell us a little bit more about the menstrual product drive.
Yeah, so the menstrual product drive that Apex Feminists are doing is a drive to help women who can't obtain the necessities to live with their period. So we're going to help them get those necessities. And we're super excited about it. We hope that everyone participates. Yeah.
Yeah, make sure you guys donate.
So tell us about the songs that you've been listening to this Women's History Month.
Okay, so I have some pretty good songs. My first one is by Maggie Rogers. And Maggie Rogers is a super cool person. She's a great singer, a great songwriter, and she's also super smart. She's going to Harvard right now, so she does it all. This is her song, Light On.
Believe me now, if I told you I got caught up in a wave, almost gave it away.
Okay, that was that song. And then next we have Haim. Haim is a band that consists of three sisters, and they do it all once again. They play the guitar, the drums, and they also sing, and they are just an amazing group, and I really love them. The song that I have for y'all today is The Steps. Okay, perfect. And then next I have Lauryn Hill. Lauryn Hill is another amazing songwriter and singer. She's really paved the way for Black female artists. And she is also an actress. So she does it all once again. We have some pretty cool female artists right here. All right, so this is Can't Take My Eyes Off of You.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
Thank you, Sydney, for sharing those songs. Make sure you guys follow at Apex Feminist for all updates on the Feminist Club here at Apex.
Thanks to the Ox crew for that women's theme soundtrack.
On the subject of Women's History Month, we conducted a little social experiment.
Can you define women's suffrage?
That is the woman's right to vote.
The women's right to vote.
Women's suffrage is the right to vote for women.
Do you think students at Apex High School know what women's suffrage is?
Unfortunately, no, because not a whole lot of them are paying attention in history or civics class.
No, definitely not.
I'd be curious to see.
Do you think we should end women's suffrage?
Yes.
No.
No comment.
Wait.
No.
Yes.
Definitely.
Why?
Because women don't deserve to suffer.
It's women's right to vote.
Yeah.
You want to end women's right to vote?
No.
Do you know what that means?
Yes.
What does it mean?
Vote. No, I actually don't know what it means.
End women's suffrage.
Yes.
What's women's suffrage?
Women's rights, not having like equal pay and just not just having as much as the boys.
So you wanna end the equal rights?
Yes, I want women to be treated exactly how men are treated.
What's women's suffrage?
When women suffer.
It's women's right to vote.
Wait, what?
Should we end women's suffrage?
Yes.
Why?
Because they be suffering.
Should we end women's suffrage?
Yes.
Yes.
No. Yes.
What's women's suffrage?
women's suffrage?
We
should not end women's suffrage.
What's women's suffrage?
When a woman suffers.
Nope, it's women's right to vote.
Oh, yeah, I love women.
So, Cougars, this Women's History Month and always, remember,
women's suffrage is women's right to vote, which we gained in 1920 with the 19th Amendment.
Before we go, last Friday, our field was dedicated to the beloved Coach Todd, and we have a piece observing this event.
And remember, Cougars, in honor of Coach Todd, stay peak.
When I was in ninth grade, I actually played soccer for Coach Todd at North Garner Junior High School. And that was his first year coaching any school team ever, so I was on his first soccer team. And just the enthusiasm he had for learning how to coach soccer.
My favorite memory from Coach Todd was the time at practice when it had rained that day, and he made us walk the field for like 25 minutes to try to find a single dry spot so we could practice.
Covering him in the yearbook in a variety of ways was such a pleasure. You could tell just by the ways people spoke about him, the impact that he had on their lives. I'm glad that we're able to record that forever.
Coach Todd was probably the most supportive person, not just coach, but supportive figure that I've ever known in my life. There's never a mean or rude thing to come out of his mouth. He was always supportive, and you'll hear that from anyone who talks about him.
Coach Todd was easily one of the best coaches I've ever had, but I didn't really look at him as a coach. He was like more of a mentor for me.
He not only was a supportive person on the soccer field, but off the soccer field, he was supportive and he was interested in what you did outside of the school. He was interested in your personal life.
In the 9 years, Coach Todd was always full of some mischief. The main thing that comes out of Coach Todd is his caring and supportive nature of everybody.
I'll always remember about and really miss about Coach Todd is just our conversations and his smile.
We are proud to announce that from this moment forward, the field at Cougar Stadium will forever be known as the Kevin E. Todd Field.